In yesterday's session, we have discussed about some basics of Selenium, basics of automation, difference between QTP and Selenium, and we have came to Selenium, different what are the different components of Selenium, and we have taken Selenium IDE first and started the installation of Selenium IDE. That's it. That is the only topic what we have did yesterday. Selenium IDE. Now, let us see some different concepts inside the Selenium IDE. This is the last topic what we are going to learn on Selenium IDE, as Selenium IDE is getting outdated. And no more Selenium IDE is getting used in industry anymore. That's why we are going to stop using Selenium IDE by today itself and move to Selenium WebDriver from tomorrow session onwards, from next session onwards. Now, what we have did yesterday, we have installed Selenium IDE. You know the installation of Selenium IDE now, right? How to install Selenium IDE, everyone? Yes. Now, let us start recording and playing back, and what are the difficulties what we will be facing during the record and playback, and some more concepts on the Selenium IDE. Go to tools, Selenium IDE. This is the Selenium IDE. See, as I said, I am going to work on an application. In future also, I am going to work on an application called demo.actitime.com. demo.actitime.com. This is the application what I am going to use very widely. First, let me explain about this application. Later on, I will start with working with Selenium IDE. What is this application meant for? First of all, before that, I will give you the credentials for you. As soon as you open demo.actitime.com, if you want to log in, right, you will get the username and password here itself. If I change the username and password, you can get the username and password here itself, whatever it might be. Okay, just log in into this application, admin, manager. What is this application? What is this ActiTime application? First, see, if you are working in a company like TCS or CTS, some other companies, in a single company, there will be multiple projects running. Am I correct? Yes or no? Yes. In a single company, there will be multiple projects. Each and every project will have different login times and logout times. Few projects will be having morning 8 o'clock to evening 5 o'clock. Few projects will be having 11 o'clock to 8 o'clock. Like the different timings will be there, and the employees will log in into different times and log out at the different time. There should be an application to track the login time and log out time of the employees and verify whether all the employees are spending sufficient time in office or not. There should be an application, right? That application is nothing but this ActiTime application. This is a time tracking application. Time tracking application. Disconnected. Okay, fine. Navata, are you there? Yes. This is just a time tracking application. Just to track the time of employees, they will use. Here, we can create different projects, different customers, different users. Associate users with the project, all those things can be done here in the ActiTime application. How to do that, we will be seeing slowly, one after the other. Now, you know how to log in into this application and log out of this application, right? Open demo.actitime.com, enter admin manager, click on login and log out. You know how to do login, logout, all those things here, right? Don't use www.actitime.com. This is demo.actitime.com. This is not www.actitime.com. If you open www.actitime.com, it will open some other website. Use demo.actitime.com. Now, open browser, open tools, open tools, go to Selenium IDE. This is the Selenium IDE tool. Now, whatever the topics I am going to teach you from here onwards, I am going to create a new folder for you. Under classes, I am going to create a new folder and name it as a batch 88. Batch 88. At the end of the classes, you will be ending with at least some 50 Java programs, some 50 WebDriver programs, all those things. All these programs, whatever I am going to write, will be under this folder. Under this folder, you can collect. I will zip it and I will send it to you at the end of this training session, what we are going to see. That's why I am creating a new folder for you. Everything will be softwares, notes, everything will be under this folder. If I forgot to put it under this folder also, just remind me to put it under this folder. Now, this is the browser and this is my Selenium IDE. What is the Selenium IDE? It is just a record and playback tool. Whatever I do here, that will get recorded here. By default, the record button is on. Whatever I do here, that will get recorded here. The same thing, I can run it. Now, I am going to open demo.iqtime.com. demo.iqtime.com, enter admin, manager, click on login, done. Sorry, I did a small mistake. I didn't click on login. Yeah, tell me. Yes. Yeah, if you click on stop recording, now recording, right, it will stop. Okay. Whatever the test cases you want, try to execute that once manually here. That everything will get recorded here. Yeah, or else if you just play, it will automatically get stopped. Okay. No need to stop. It is better to stop and start it. It's a process what we follow. Okay, now open demo.actitime.com. Open demo.actitime.com. Enter admin, manager. Click on login. Done, right? Now I'll stop recording. Okay, now I have recorded login test case. Now I'll close the browser and run these steps again. This is the run button. This is also the run button. I will explain about all the buttons later slowly. Now, slow down the speed of execution, or else if you run right, what happens? It will open demo.actitime.com, enter admin manager, click on login. It is doing very quickly. You are unable to see the speed of execution, right? That's why it is always preferred to run in slow mode. Slow down the speed of execution, log out, open a fresh browser by killing all the session. Then if you run this once again, right, it will open demo.actitime.com. Now it enters admin, it enters manager and click login button. Now it's done. Are you getting this? This is one test case what I have recorded. Let me record this again. Can you tell me how to do this? How to record the test case? First, open Selenium IDE. Go to Tools and open Selenium IDE. Done. Okay, next. First, check whether the record button is on or not. By default, it will be on only, but make sure the record button is on. Now, open demo.actitime.com. Okay, done. Next. See, now someone asked, first I have opened the URL, but it has not got recorded here, right? As soon as I move to the first step, it will record, it will show you the as soon as I move to the second step, that is nothing but entering the admin, it has recorded both the steps here. Admin, manager, click on login, all the steps got recorded. Yes, right? Now this is one test case for me. I need to save this test case. I have stopped this. Now I need to save this test case because tomorrow when I come this, I no need to record this again. I want to open the same test case and I need to run this. So that what I can do, I can go to file, save test case. Under batch 88, I will save this test case. I will create a new folder called IDE, Selenium IDE. IDE. Under this, I will save this test cases, login test case, login, save. I saved this test cases, login. Are you getting this what I am doing? Now, I will close this, go home today, come back tomorrow again. I will come back tomorrow again, open the fresh browser, go to tools, open Selenium IDE. Again, I no need to record this. Already yesterday I have recorded and kept a test case, right? Try to open that. Others are able to catch Gayatri, Navata? Yeah, yeah. Navata, are you able to catch? Yes. What about Devapriya? Yes, yes. If you have any doubts, you can ask me then and there itself. Now, yesterday I have recorded one test case and saved it as login. Go to that test case, go to file, open. Open that login test case. Automatically that will get open. Now, you can run this test case. Slow down the speed of execution and run this. Now it opens demo.actitime.com. Admin manager, click on login. That's it, done. Are you getting this? How to save the test case? Just take down in your notes. See, only for yesterday's and today's session, you will not be having much notes. From tomorrow onwards, you will be having notes a little bit. And slowly after 5 or 6 more classes, you will be having a regular notes. Until that, you will not be having much notes. Just take down the running notes as how to save a test case. How to save a test case and reuse the test case. Just take down in your notes so that you will remember. How to save a test case and reuse the test case. Yeah, open it. How you save any file in Notepad and open it in the same way? Okay, in the same way. Now, I am going to record one more test case now. If you want to record one more test case here, right click, new test case. It opens a new test case here. Start recording the test case. The same test case I am going to do. Start recording. This is the record button, right? Now record button is in off. I will start recording. And start recording the test case. Open demo.actitime.com. Open demo.actitime.com. Enter admin. Enter manager. And click on login. After clicking on login, I need to log out also. I need to log out also. I need to log out. After clicking on login, I need to log out. Done with log out. I have done with log out. Now, this first step is opening the browser. Second step is entering admin in the username text box. Third step is entering manager in the password text box. Fourth step is clicking on login button. Fifth step is clicking on logout button. Are you understanding these steps? What it is getting recorded here? Yes. Now, if I run these steps, it has to log in and log out, right? Yes. Try to run this. It is opening browser, opening URL, enters admin, enter manager, click on login. Afterwards, it is throwing an error. It is throwing an error. It is throwing in a red color here and throwing an error here, right? See, why it is throwing an error? Everything whatever I have did is correct. Yeah. See, if you want to run line by line, right? It is easy to run line by line. First, if you want to open, just double click on that line. Just double click on that line. That line will get executed. It is opening the URL. Double click here. It is entering admin. Double click here. It will enter manager. Are you able to execute line by line here? Yes. Double click on login button. It is getting executed. Then double click on logout. It is getting logout here. But if I run continuously, it is not getting logout. If I run continuously, it is not getting logout. Are you understanding the problem? Devapriya, are you understanding the problem here? Enter admin manager, click on login. Afterwards, it is throwing an error. Yes, absolutely correct. Devapriya, are you understanding? Yes. Why? Because it is opening the browser, you entering username, password, login. As soon as it clicks on login, it is trying to search for logout link. But it is taking some time to load, right? It is taking some time to load. In between this login step and logout step, you need to wait for some certain period of time. You need to wait for certain period of time so that it will not throw any error. That is what the problem what we have found. That is the problem what we have found. Let us look into the solution, how to solve that. What is the solution what you want to give? Between login and logout, we need to after clicking on login, I need to wait for some time. That is the solution, right? Yes. After clicking on login, I need to wait for some time. What you want to do is single click on this login step. Instead of click, what you do is use click and wait. Use click and wait. Single click here. Come and edit the statement. By default, it will be click. By default, it will be click. Instead of click, use click and wait. So that after clicking, it will wait for some time to load. How much time it waits, how to change the time, that we will see it later. It will wait for some time. It will wait for some time. After the page loads, it will come to the next line of execution. If you just use click, right, as soon as it clicks, it comes to the next line of execution. But if you use click and wait, it will wait for some time till the page is getting loaded. Till the page is getting loaded. Now I have used click and wait. Now if I run this, it will open the URL. It will enter admin, manager, click on login, and it will wait for some time. Once the page gets loaded, then it comes to the next line of execution. It clicks on logout and it comes out. Now it is happening correctly, right? Others, are you getting what I'm telling? Yes. After clicking on login, see, after recording any script, you need to check when you run that, you need to check wherever you need to use wait times, you need to use that properly. Or else script won't run. Script won't run. Now, It will wait for some time. Enter admin manager, click on login. It is waiting for some time. If the net is slow and it is taking 20 seconds, it will wait for 20 seconds, then it comes to the next line of execution. Automatically it will synchronize based upon the amount of time it is getting loaded. It will synchronize automatically, but maximum it will wait for 30 seconds. Maximum it will wait for 30. Have you understood the difference between click and wait? Click will just click and it comes to the next line of execution suddenly, but click and wait will wait for some time. That is the difference between click and wait. Now how long it will wait? It will wait for a maximum of 30 seconds. Even though if it doesn't load within 13 seconds, it will throw you an error telling that it is unable to identify the logout link. Yes, we can. Next step, we are going to learn that. Okay, but it will wait for a maximum of 30 seconds. But if your internet is very slow and each page is taking more than 30 seconds, if it is taking 40 seconds, And if you need to wait for a maximum of 1 minute, you can change the time. That is default timeout value. That is called as default timeout value. You can change the default timeout value also. How to change the default timeout value inside your Selenium IDE? Go to options. Here you have got a default timeout value, right? Default timeout value of recorded command in milliseconds. Here they have given 30,000 milliseconds. If you want, you can change it to 60,000 milliseconds or 90,000 milliseconds for 1.5 minute, like that. And if you click on OK, it will take that amount of time what you have given. That option is available in options in Selenium IDE. That is how to change the default timeout value. Now, have you understood the difference between click and wait? How to change the default timeout value? Yes. Take down in your notes. Difference between click and wait. See, only yesterday's topic and today's topic, I will be little bit fast because this is not that much important. From tomorrow's topic onwards, it will be little bit slow. You can understand. This also you can understand, but I will be moving little bit faster because of not that much important. Tomorrow, just remind me to give you the syllabus. I will give you the contents. That is syllabus, so that you can keep on tracking how much you have completed. Now, yes, of course it's there. Already I have promised you to give you Java also, right? No need to know about anything. If you know also, just try to forget everything, because I will be teaching you in a different way where it will be very easy to learn everything. Okay. Finish difference between click and wait, right? Next, how to change the default timeout value. In Selenium IDE, go to options. Arrow mark options. Change the default timeout value. Where UEFT files, that is something different for file name, that is which is related to coding inside that UEFT 8, all those things, nothing related to QTP. Are you something expecting which is related to QTP? Nothing which is related to that. Don't save. I'm not saving. I'm going to close this and start from the beginning again. Let me delete everything which is there inside that and start from the beginning again. Now, in today's session, what we have learned, how to record, how to run, what are the problems what we will be facing while we are recording and running, like click and wait, how to resolve that we have learned. Next, we have saw about how to change the default timeout value. These are the steps what we have completed until now. Now, go to Tools, open Selenium IDE. I am going to start recording a new test case, demo.actitime.com. Enter admin manager, click on login. After clicking on login, I need to log out. If I run this test case, will it run? Yeah. For that, how to solve this error? Single click on this statement, then instead of click, what I have to do? Use click and wait. Use click and wait. Now, if I run this, will it run properly? Yes, it will run properly. Slow down the speed of execution and try to run this. Open URL, enter admin, manager, click on login. Click on login. Why it is throwing error? I don't know. Okay, let me run this once again. Sometimes due to some unnecessary issues, it will. Let me run this again. Enter admin, manager, click on login. Again, it is throwing the same error. Oh, there is nothing like small a I have given. It is actually capital A. Click and wait. I have given small a. That's the problem. Let me run this again. There is no command like click and small a. That's why. Enter admin, manager, click on login. Then it clicks on logout and it comes out. Login, logout, verifying the login scenario is done here, right? Let me save this test case. How to save this test case? File, save the test case. I will name this as login or some name. Save the test case. I have saved this test case. This is one test case what I have saved. Let me open a new test case and record a new test case again. Let me record a new test case again. Open demo.activetime.com. Oh, sorry, I forgot to start recording. Start recording again. Start recording again. Demo.activetime.com. Enter admin manager. Click on login. After clicking on login, do something inside. Do one more, some more things. Click on tasks and do something inside the tasks, like creating a task, deleting a task, or do something inside this. Okay, try to do it by yourself. By yourself. After finishing doing something inside this tasks, click on logout. This test case is related to doing something inside the tasks. Am I correct? Now, if I run this, will it run properly? First, it will open ActiveTime application. Then it will enter admin. It will enter admin. It will enter manager. It will click on login. Then it will try to click on tasks. Will it run here properly? If I run continuously? Yes or no? After clicking on login, this is clicking on tasks button. This is clicking on tasks button. After clicking on login, will it try to click on tasks button? If I run continuously. Yeah. At the time, will it click on tasks button here? If I run continuously, I am logging out. Let me run this continuously. Let me run this continuously. Run this. It is opening demo.activetime.com. Enter admin manager. Click on login. Afterwards, it is throwing an error here. Why? Loaded. Page is not getting loaded here. Are you getting this, others? I am not getting from Navata and. Yes. Navata and Gayatri, are you able to get it? Yes. Now, for that, how to solve this error? After clicking on login, I need to wait for some time. How to solve that error? See, instead of this click of login, you need to use click and wait. You need to use click and wait so that error will be solved. Now, log out of. Let me run from the beginning again. Run this. Now what happens? It opens demo.activetime.com, enter admin, enter manager, click on login, then click on tasks. Click on tasks. Then click on logout and come out. If you have did something after clicking on task, if you have did something like clicking on create new task and entering something, all those things will get recorded here. All those things will get recorded here. Normally for clicks, we have to use click and wait. That is the most widely errors what we will be getting. 95% of the times. Okay. You know how to solve that errors, right? Okay. That is the major errors what we will be getting. Or else, in the log, you will be seeing that error, what you will be getting. If you go through that error, you can come to know. It is showing that it cannot click on this tasks button. So that the previous thing you can trace out and see. Later on we will be seeing how to write these steps here. At that time you will come to know. Okay. Now, this is one test case again. This is login and logout test case and this is related to tasks, right? Let me save this test case. How to save this test case? Go to file, save test case and I will name this as tasks. I will name these test cases tasks. There are two test cases here, right? Now, let me record one more test case. Open demo.activetime.com. Open demo.activetime.com. Enter admin manager. Oh, sorry, I didn't start recording at all. Extremely sorry. Open demo.activetime.com. Enter admin manager. Manager. Then click on login. Let me record this once again. I did a mistake here by not recording properly. Let me do that from the beginning. Start recording. Open demo.activetime.com. Open demo.activetime.com. Enter admin manager. Click on login. Click on reports. After clicking on reports, do something inside the reports by yourself. I am not doing that now. Do something inside the reports, create a chart or create a new report or something. And after finishing everything, click on logout so that all the steps will get recorded here. Now, if I run this test case, will it run? Why? Yeah, again the same error. Instead of click, you need to use click and wait. Yeah. Yeah, that is by default. Sometimes it will take click and wait. Sometimes it will take click. That is depend upon how it is coded at the back end of the Selenium IDE. Sometimes the same script, if you try to record once again, right? Sometimes it will take a click for all the statements. Sometimes it will take click and wait for all the statements. Sometimes it will take click for some statements and click and wait for some statements. You cannot expect the same thing every time. That's your doubt, right? Exactly. Yes. Yeah, that is depend upon the how speed you do the actions here. No, that depends upon how they have coded at the back end. You cannot expect that same every time. Okay, but when you see the script, you can come to understand why the problem is existing there, right? You know how to solve that, right? Yeah. that no one can't do, no one can't expect that, because that is how they have coded at the back end of this. Okay, now if I run this, it will open demo.activetime.com, enter admin, enter manager, click on login, wait for some time. Now it is waiting. Then click on reports. Now click on reports.
Then click on logout.
And come out. Done. Now save this test case. I am going to save this as reports. I have three test cases here, right? I have three test cases. One is login, logout. Another is tasks. Another is reports. Three test cases I have. Now, what is test case and what is test suite? Do anyone know what is test case and what is test suite? Yes. Good. Combination of test cases or bunch of test cases is called as test suite. Normally, what is suite? Suite. We tell that a suitcase, it contains collection of objects inside that. Right? In the same case, test suite is collection of test cases or bunch of test cases. We have three test cases here, right? I am going to make these three test cases into a test suite. I am going to make these three test cases into a test suite. How to do that? That is what I am going to guide you. Go to file, go to save test suite as, and I am going to save this test suite as first suit. Now all these three test cases are under a suit called first suit. Are you getting this? Yes or no? Now close this. I am going to tools, open Selenium IDE. Now go to file, open. See, if I open this first, right, this is the first is the suit. If I open, all three test cases will get open. Are you getting this? This first is a suit here. Now go to tools, Selenium IDE, go to file, open. Now if you open only login, right, only login test case will get open, because you have opened only the test case. But if you go to file, open, and if you open first, all three test cases will get open. Are you getting this? Now slow down the speed of execution, and if you run this right, only login test case will run. But if you run using this button, play entire test suite, it will run all the three test cases continuously one after the other. This is used to run only the active test case. Now the active test case is login. If you double click here, now the active test case is tasks. And if you run using this button, only tasks test case will run. But if you run using this button, right, it will run the entire suite. Now let me run this test suite. First it is running login. It is opening ActiveTime, enter admin manager, click on login, and it will click on logout. See, automatically it will jump to tasks now. After clicking on logout, automatically it has jumped to tasks. Now it is opening demo.activetime.com, enter admin manager, click on login. Then it will click on logout. Automatically it will jump to reports after finishing these steps. It has jumped. It will start. All the three test cases, it is running continuously one after the other, right? Now, if you have 50 set of test cases and if you want to make different suits, you can make different suits and you can run. You can run. Are you getting this? What is test case and what is test suit? File menu. Where? Yeah. New test suit. If you want to create a new test suit, you can create a new test suit. Open test suit. That is nothing but open. Alternative for this. Everything are alternatives. That's it. Nothing beyond that. You learn only the steps what I have did. That is more than sufficient. Okay. Now, I have opened this test suit. If I right click here, add a new test case. I am going to add a new test case here. Start recording. Open demo.actytime.com. Open demo.actytime.com. Enter admin manager. Click on login. Click on login. Look here. Discuss later. You can discuss later. Look here. Now, I am going to click on users here. I am going to click on users. Then I am going to click on logout. Now, if I run only this test case, will it run properly? Click and wait. For this also I need to use click and wait. Yes, correct. Absolutely correct. Now if I run this, it will run. It will open demo.actytime.com, enter manager, click on login. Afterwards, it will click on users and run this. Now, go to file, save test case. I am going to name this as users. Is this users test case is falling under that first suit? Yes, it will fall because I have opened the suit and I am doing all these actions. That's why it will fall under that suit. Now, under that suit, there are 4 test cases. I have already opened the suit and I am doing the actions inside that suit only, right? That's why everything will be saved under that suit. Okay, are you getting this? Now, there are 4 test cases under this suit. Now, if I run this right, now all the 4 test cases, it will run one after the other continuously. Now, run this. First, it opens login and does the login test case. This is all about the difference between test case and test suite. Now it has jumped to tasks. It is doing tasks. After doing everything with the tasks, automatically it will jump to. Then click on users. Yes, now user test case is also done. All the 4 test cases, it is running continuously one after the other, right? Yes, done. Now, if you want to delete any test case in this suit, what you can do, right click, delete. It will delete. Now only 3 test cases are there under this suit. Now only 3 test cases because I have deleted tasks. Are you getting this? If you want to delete that permanently from that, delete it. Now only 3 test cases are under that suit. Now open Mozilla Firefox browser. Now I am going to tools, open Selenium IDE. Now if I open that suit, file, open. If I open first suit, only 3 test cases are there inside that suit. Am I correct? Yes. Now, I am going to open Selenium IDE. Now, if I record a new test case now, I am going to start recording new test case. Demo.actitime.com. Enter admin. Enter admin. Enter manager. Click on login. Click on login. Then click on tasks. Then click on tasks. Then click on logout. Click on logout. Now if I run this, will it run properly? Yeah, again I need to use wait time. Correct all the script errors now. Done with. Now if I run this, it has to run properly. Run. Opens demo.actitime.com. Enter admin, manager. Click on login. Wait for some time. Then click on tasks. And click on logout. Click on tasks, then click on logout. Click on logout. Click on logout. Done. Now I am going to save this test case. I am going to save this file, save test case. I will save this test cases tasks. Now will this tasks test case will be under the first suit? How? No, not in the folder. I have saved in the folder location. But did I open that suit and did that actions here? Separately I have did. So that it will not fall under that particular suit. Even though if you put under the same folder, you didn't open that suit and did that action. You didn't do like that. You have did it separately. So that if you open that suit now, right? It will open only three test cases. It will not open tasks because tasks is done separately. Am I correct? Open the first suit so that you will get only three. There is no tasks here now. Are you getting? Now, my question, I want to get the tasks here. How to do that? I want to add the task test case to this suit. How to do that? Right click here, add test case. Not new test case, add test case and select this tasks, whatever you have recorded. Now save this. It will be automatically saved to this suit now. Are you getting? Add new test cases, you have to add a new test case. Add test case is nothing but the existing test case you will be getting here. Are you understanding this? Now if you open, go to file, Selenium IDE, file, open and go to the first. All the four test cases it has opened. Are you getting this? How to add new test cases to the suit? How to add the... See, some of your friends will be giving few test cases. You will be adding to that folder. And you will open that particular suit. And you will be adding those test cases here. This is the format. How if some of your friends is giving the test case, how to add that to your suit. Are you understanding the difference between test case and test suit? How to add the test cases to the suit? All those things? Now, take down questions as. Question as, what is test case and a test suit? What is test case and a test suit? So that you will remember whatever the things, whatever I have said now. What is test case and a test suit? What is test case and a test suit? Okay. Shall we move to the next topic? Any doubts? Okay. Let's move to the next topic. Until now, we are recording everything, right? We are just recording everything. From now onwards, what we are going to do is, I am going to do the coding here. I am not going to record anymore. I am going to start doing the coding here. What is the first step what I need to do? No, I am not going to record anymore. I am going to start writing the script. What is the first step in my script? Forget about record and playback. I am not going to record anymore. What is the first step in your script? Good. I need to open the URL. I need to open the URL called demo.activetime.com. Single click on the statement here. That is an empty statement. Command, you want to give us open. Command, you will be giving us open. In the base URL, you will be providing the URL what you are going to open. In the base URL, you will be giving the URL what you are going to open. That's all. You can open the URL. Double click on the statement. It will open the demo.activetime.com. Are you getting this? If you want this remaining URL, extension URL, you can put it in the target, or else you can just leave it also. Without that also, it will work properly. This is how you can open the URL. Are you getting this? Come, do a single click here. Write the statement as open to open the URL. Done. What is the next step what you are going to do? Yeah. Yeah. Everything are case sensitive. Highly case sensitive. Open. Done. That's why when you type something here, right? Select from the help menu here. If you do some mistakes also, see, if I give capital O also here, you cannot get it. If you do some mistakes also here, try to get it from this help menu, so that you will not make that mistake. You will not make that mistake. Okay. What is the next statement? Directly, can I click on login? Yeah. Where I need to enter? In the username text box. I need to enter the username in the username text box. I need to type in the username text box. In that case, the command is type. Target is nothing but where you are going to type. Value is nothing but what you are going to type. Where you are going to type? Username. You cannot directly type as username here. What it takes is, it takes element locator. In Selenium, how many element locators are there? In Selenium, 8 element locators are there. In Selenium, there are 8 element locators. Do you know what are those? No, I have not said to you. Let me explain you about. This is very, very, very important interview question. How many element locators are there and what are they? There are 8 element locators. Element locators. Take down in your notes. ID. Follow the order also. Don't miss the order. ID, name, link text, XPath, CSS selector, class name, tag name, partial link text. These are the 8 element locators available in Selenium. Take down in your notes. Done? 2, 3, one more? Done. Okay. How many element locators are there? 8. What are those? ID, name, link text, XPath, CSS selector, class name, tag name, and partial link text. Don't miss the order also. First, try to identify the ID of this element. Now, you need to identify this username text box, right? That's your goal. You want to identify this username text box. Since you want to type something here in this username text box, you need to identify the element locator. First, try to identify the ID of this element. Right click. Inspect element with Firebug. This is the source code of this element. This is the source code of this element. What it is highlighting in the blue color? Right click, inspect element with Firebug. It will show you the source code of this element. Okay, this complete thing is the source code of this element. Whatever it is highlighted here. Are you getting this? Now, this element is built with input tag. This element is built with input tag and it has different attributes like ID, class, type, value, name, placeholder. Each and everyone is an attribute here. ID attribute has a value called username. Class attribute has a value called text field. Type attribute has a value called the text. Value attribute has a value called null. There is nothing inside that. Name attribute has a value called username. And placeholder attribute has a value called username. And input is the tag name. This is the tag name. This is attribute and attribute value. Attribute and attribute value. Different set of attribute with attribute values will be there. That is how normally an element will be built. Now, do you have ID attribute here? What is the ID attribute value? Username. If you have ID, take ID directly. If you have ID, take ID. What is ID value? ID equal to username. For this element, I have ID equal to username. You can use that element locator. Which element locator I can use? Others. ID is the element locator here. ID's value is username. Are you getting this? Okay. Which first choose which element locator you are going to use. You are going to use ID as an element locator. ID value is nothing but username. In that case, you can give ID equal to username. It takes element locator there always. Element locator with value. Okay. What is value what you will be passing here? Admin, because what you are going to pass there, that is the same thing. Now, if you double click here, it will execute that statement. Done, right? Can you tell me the same thing for password here? What is the command what I want to do here? Type. What is the target? How to identify the target? Right click. Inspect element with Firebug. This is the source code of this element. Do you have ID attribute here? What are the attributes what it has? Can you tell me what are the attributes what it is having? Input is not an attribute. That is the tag name. Leave it. Class. Type. Value. Name. Good. Name and placeholder. These are the attributes what it is having. Does it have ID attribute here? Okay. In that case, I cannot use ID as an element locator. What is the next element locator what I have? If you don't have ID? Name. If you don't have ID, type. Is that the order what I have? How many element locators are there and what are those? Link text. In that, do you have any type attribute there? Element locator there? No, right? First, you have ID. If you don't have ID, then you have to look for name. Okay, are you getting this, what I'm telling? Yes, if you don't have ID, look for name. Do you have name attribute here? What is the name attribute value? PWD. In that case, if you don't have ID, go for name. Name equal to PWD. Done. What you will be passing in value? Manager. Double click on that. It will enter. Are you understanding how this script is getting recorded? This is order. Now, what is the next step? What you want to do? Login. What I want to do with login? Do I want to type on login button? I want to click. Instead of click, normally I will be using click and wait, right? Right. Next, what I want to do, I need to type something. I mean, where I need to click? I need to mention that in the target. How to identify the target element? Right click on that element. Good. Inspect element with Firebug. This is that. I don't have anything here. Just go to its parent. It is having that ID, right? You can take ID. If you don't have anything, just go to its parent. Take this ID value. Copy this. Now what I can do here in the target? What I need to mention in the target? ID equal to login button, whatever I have copied from there, right? Just double click on that, it will click on login button. This is how to write scripts by yourself. You can write script by yourself, but no need to do all those things. Just try to record and playback. Now, why I have said you this concept is how to identify the elements we are going to start learning from tomorrow onwards. Okay. If you go home and try to do right click on any element, you will not get this inspect element with Firebug option. You will not get this because you have not installed Firebug. How to install Firebug, all those things, I will let you know in the upcoming class. Are you getting this? Okay. You will get this option, inspect element option. You can use that option also if you still need that. Okay, if you still need that, you can go with inspect element option itself. Later on, I will let you know how to install the Firebug. Once you install Firebug only, you will get that option. Are you clear with these topics what I have said until now? What we have covered in today's session, how to record, how to playback, how to save the test case, how to save many test cases and make it as a test suite. While we are recording and playing back, we will face some problems between click and wait. We have resolved that those errors. Then next we have saw about test cases and test suite. Then we have started how to write script by ourselves. These are the different topics what we have learned in Selenium IDE. Already I have mentioned many times Selenium IDE is not that much important, but try to practice once and leave it. Later on we will see why we have learned all these topics. Then we have just started with how many element locators are there. Nothing we have saw about element locators. We will be seeing about in detail about that from tomorrow's topic onwards. What is the purpose of element locators? To identify any element, we will use element locators, right? Until unless we identify, we cannot perform action. To do any automation, we need to identify the element and perform action on that element. Right? From tomorrow onwards, we will be starting with the core topics and everything is very, very important. You cannot miss even a single topic from tomorrow onwards. That's all about today's topic. If you have liked this video, please click on the like button and do not forget to click on the subscribe button to get the latest videos on Selenium as well as the upcoming videos on